So this is the lab space where we build a lot of this stuff. Over here is the PTSD application. Right now you're looking at your feet if you were to be looking down. And what you'll see is as you move your head, what you see up there is right. What you'll see in the head-mounted display. And you want to have a seat?
Great.
We'll put you through.
So you take the soldier after their experience, they come into one of these?
Yeah.
Right.
Now you drive with this game controller. Put this in your hand and these buttons here.
Yeah, I'm driving.
Now, if you were a patient in therapy, I would spend a number of sessions with you just getting to know you and know what your experiences were in Iraq. And we would try to recreate it to some degree at a very mild level initially so that you could get used to the simulation and used to talking about what you went through and then gradually ramp it up. So I'd have to find out what time of day or weather, overcast condition or dusk or night, morning light, night vision. If you look to the right, it's an empty seat, or we add a passenger. If there was somebody in the turret, we can add them in as well. We could always put you up in the turret. And so we can begin to customize the setting. And as you drive down the road, I would be asking you to tell me about your experience when you were over there.
Now, if I was saying, well, you know, we were getting towards a city, and that's when things got bad.
Okay.
Do you have...
Yep. Well, you'll be approaching a small village area shortly. Was there a vehicle in front of you, or should I get rid of that?
No.
Okay, we'll get rid of it then. Now you're approaching this danger zone here.
And you guys base this on a place?
From a lot of video and photographs. Now, as you're approaching this area, you may want to take it easy because you don't know what's going to happen up ahead.
Oh, right.
How's your passenger holding up?
Oh, I'm afraid to look.
Yeah.
Oy, the guy would see this and then remember, oh, we...
Exactly, exactly. Now, you're also noticing you're feeling the vibration.
Right.
That's something we can add or take away. We feel that trying to add multi-sensory input is helpful because it allows for more of an immersive experience. We also have a smell machine that pumps out smells like gunpowder, cordite, smoke.
Yeah, I was going to ask.
Smell is extremely relevant for memory and emotion.
Yeah.
I can introduce the smell of burning rubber, garbage, body odor, gunpowder. Hmm. And the way we do this is essentially open up these smell bottles that have little pellets in them that are embedded with the scent and then put them into the chamber here. Close this up. We have a control interface that allows me to add in specific smells. I can put it on high so it really cranks out the smell, or I can put it on low and just gradually waft out the scent. The beauty of a computer simulation is that you can control everything that goes on in the environment. Mm-hmm. The real world is hard to control.